Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to peek over my shoulder as I diddle-daddle around in Lifeless Planet. It looks like we are even more closer to some sort of culmination because we've followed Miss Aelita here, which is my own little nickname, just for fun. And she's taken us to this gate, and it appears we need to power the gate up. Also, there's a volcano. Jump through some lava. Also, I haven't seen any collectible minerals for a very long time. I wonder if that's just oversight or if there aren't actually any. We're down there, and the volcanic environment started messing with her vitals, and we had to help her up here. Jet pack or two. To start exploring on my own again. Just a regular rock. How sad. There are certain areas that I suspect might be explorable. Work. I need to find the green goop or the green glob and put it. Oh, okay. So we have to do something here. We have limited jetpack capability. Learned from it. Oh, so this, I think this device is like coupled with the other, but I also had the idea that the local indigenous life forms might be just sort of sitting inside the rock. Is it on? No. what we need to do here then. There was another rock formation like this one at the other site, and you just had to push the stones so that they are level with each other, or like so that they form the circle. Complete the circle. They have to be in the middle, so let's start by pushing this one. Can I operate the arm here? Oh, I can't operate the arm. Well, fuck. Can I operate it from here? Oh well. And I can't push them. Oh, okay, I can just use them as stepping stones. That will work too. Easy there. Yeah, a few episodes earlier in one area you had to push this sort of thing into place, and it transmitted like a blow. Yeah, I think it was used as it emitted as some sort of beam or blow that pushed away some structures. Oh, holy shit. Grab one of these, carry it over there, you know the drill. Swoosh. Life forms, do that. Can I operate them now? No. Okay. Sink. In the GOG game review, somebody pointed out how some or another puzzle in the Inferno region was obnoxious, but I think they might have been referring to the lava jump thingy, because maybe it was unclear in certain spots. I don't know. Basically, coming in this region, I was sort of worried that it was something that find obnoxious, but I did not. Woo. Let's not fall to death. Crystals? Artifacts? Nope. Okay then. What's that? Oh, just random texture, I think. Ta-da! Look what I made. I think we need the robot arm to push the glyphs as well. Yo! Okay. No further instructions. I take it we do what we usually do in this situation. Woohoo! Happening. We're in a new location. Oh, she's already ahead of us. Lights? But she's waiting up. So, do that check. Come on, I used up my jetpack fuel to get you up to this mountain, so... At least I get to check for collectibles. Oh, okay. She started going as well. Ah, but this is a flat area, so I can just keep an eye on her and keep an eye out for doodads as well. And her pace is faster than mine anyway, so I won't be able to properly keep up. It's a house! Oh my! The sun is out again! Yo! Uh-oh. What's this crevice? Okay, she waits for us now. Take a wild guess that the light over there marks one of our next objectives. This area is kind of big. What's this? Oh, stones, bricks, I suppose. Just stones. Okay. Something we're gonna have to interact with soonish, I guess. Wait, can't breathe again? Is it because the sun is down? Let's approach her from the path. Maybe the cutscene will kick in. Okay, can't interact with her. Like, if she's photosynthetic, then... then the lack of sunlight might prove a problem. But I'm still gonna check my doodads. Another bigger area. Wow. Okay, we've reached an end at this point, and this is the edge here. La 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 la. Crystals, no science. Aww. Did she go up? Or is she still there? Ah, she's still sitting there. Why, hello there.
К нашему большому разочарованию, экологическое воздействие нашей эксплуатации зеленого огня оказалось пагубным. Растительная жизнь стремительно исчезала. Мы думали, что этот мох был основным источником питания для всех жизненных форм на этой планете. К несчастью для нашей цивилизации здесь, уменьшение этого мха означало не только уменьшение энергии, но также и уменьшение кислорода. Люди, равно как и растения, начали умирать. На наше счастье, однако, судьба распорядилась так, что один из докторов заметил в городе нечто необъяснимое. Одна из наших сотрудниц, Аэлита, разводила сад, и он продолжал цвести. Мы пытались разгадать этот секрет, но Аэлита, непонятно почему, замкнулась в себе. Ее ребенок умер, судя по всему, от недостатка кислорода. А отказ Аэлиты сотрудничать и поделиться своим секретом вынудил нас применить силу. Солдаты пришли к ней и стали угрожать сжечь ее сад. Но когда Аэлита бросилась защищать свои растения, они стали расти. Они реагировали на ее прикосновения. Это оживляло их. Тогда Аэлиту, расцененную как средство к достижению цели, схватили, заперли и стали проводить над ней ужасные эксперименты. Мы страшно изменили ее на генетическом уровне. вкалывая в ее тело инъекции с огромным количеством ДНК, сохраненных культур местного мха. Пока она орала от боли и протеста, мы уничтожили ее человеческое происхождение на молекулярном уровне. Когда мы закончили наши эксперименты, Аэлита стала скорее растением, чем человеком. Ее глаза сделались блестящего зеленого цвета, а ее легкие наполнились углекислым газом. Но это был успех. Там, куда она ступала, следы от ее ног наполнялись маленькими ростками жизни. Мох отвечал на ее прикосновения, пробиваясь вверх из пыльной почвы. Я не жду, что Аэлита когда-нибудь сможет простить нас, но она единственная наша надежда на восстановление жизненного баланса в этом мире. Без Аэлиты эта планета останется необитаемой до конца времен.
So you're telling me that her name is actually Aelita? And I thought I was kidding. Well, then again, the game did kind of put the idea in there with the book cover, so... Hello? Something? Yo. I think she doesn't like this place. Okay, while she's resting and or recuperating and or coping and or having trouble, let's check out the next shining light maybe. Maybe this helps us somehow. Oh, this is the crater. Okay, now I get it. Can we go down there? Hey, tightrope, my favorite. Oh, well, fuck. Okay, so we have to get to the next one, I think. I mean, we have to get past the first. Word. Get onto the. I mean, we have to get past the top cord. Uh oh. Not good. So any jumping has to happen above the platform, or we are fucked. I mean, it definitely looks like we can walk this thing. But unfortunately, the other one is also very active. I mean, like it's not just scenery. Do we need to bring down whatever's up there? Let's examine. Oh no, I was already over at this end checking for dude, as hot. Let's look anyway. Check back to the house for a second. See if she's still having a moment. Oh, there seems to be something down there, so it seems that I should go down there, or at least I can go down there. Okay, still sitting. Seems safe, mostly. Ah, yes! Don't mind if I do. Yoink. First, I want to see the crater proper. There seems to be something in the middle there. Of course, with the jetpack, it wouldn't be too difficult to get the jump over the other rope, so cord, whatever. Let them do that, so we'll be checking themselves. Also, there seems to be some sort of device in the middle emitting sounds. Though that might just be the wind. Almost breaking through the clouds here. I mean, dust. I mean, ash. Para clouds. Ow. Probably should be a little bit careful. The spacesuit can take. Circled around halfway of the crater already. Nope. I'm going up there. Okay, this doesn't seem to be due to that area. Is there something on the ground? Oh yeah, there is. Let's observe that one. Ah no, that's just a minor impact crater. A crater inside a crater. Certain angles, it's almost sunny. Oh, come on. I'm exploring so well. Why you not give me doodads, game? Oh, I have reached the invisible border here. Hello. I suppose they didn't expect people to just walk into the crater. Weird sounds seem to be coming from the formation in the middle of the tunnel. Okay, that's the house there, and this is the side of the ravine. Okay, gotcha. And I'm gonna take a wild guess that I... Okay. I was gonna say that I can't just walk up from there, but it looks like I don't have to. Well then, I think we might have found the southern lab, the one that that we have door codes for. So this must be where they experimented on her. Okay, let's check out what's in the middle there. Some sort of construction here. And this is definitely what's emitting the voice. For a second there I thought I saw a glint of blue.
Первичный анализ метеорита указывает на нетипичность в сравнении с метеоритами, найденными на Земле. При дальнейшем исследовании этот метеорит казался нам частью высокотехничного инженерного сооружения. В настоящий момент мы склоняемся к предположению, что этот кратер был местом посадки более развитой расы, построившей портал и связанные с ним энергогенерирующие сооружения. Мы основали исследовательский пост на краю кратера и намерены тщательно исследовать это место, по меньшей мере, в течение следующей зимы.
What do you know? Ah, so these pieces, these are actually pieces of the meteorite slash craft. Wonder, Should I go to the lab first, or should I try to get up there? Let me go check the rope situation out really fast, because if I'm going to the lab, that might be a whole new area, and it's easier to get up from here than to backtrack more. Oh, okay, that's just the texture slipping. World is showing cracks, yo. Situation. And then I can get down to the lab from there as well. I don't have to circle the whole crater anymore. Pardon, landing site. Uh-oh. Oh my. Where were we? Oh, it saves here. Isn't that handy? I think I have my best shot if I jump up to that pipe. I realize that this might not be the intended course for the game, but hey. Oh, that was fast. Wait, so the save actually puts me on the rope, which means I must be kind of on the right track. Okay, let's try it from this side. So on one hand we need where the other rope is the lowest, but on the other hand where it's not like across the ravine. Oh, too far. No. Or should I just try to get past it? I don't know. No, it seems simpler to get to the... Oh, let's see. Nope. Splat. Oh. I'm gonna keep trying for a few times more. Oh. That doesn't count as a try. That counts as a flop. Oh, Wait. Are you telling me that I can actually get up from this side? Let's try this. This is probably not the intended way, but... except the jetpack is pushing me back. Okay, that's the lab over there. Oh. I don't think this is the intended way. It's just a surprise to survive that. Close this time? I think. Wasn't it? Here's an idea. I will stop recording here and I will keep experimenting on my own. And once I have concluded whether this is a viable option or not, I will start recording again. But for now, thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next one. Bye!